I started knowing about the battles of the oligarchy from the Ali must go crisis when we were very young. And then we had different issues with this country and with the leadership of this country. Even when Buhari came into power the first time, when he came to UBTH, when Dr. Scott Mwapa was rolling an empty trolley to go and meet him, then I was already a medical doctor and I was doing internship in the UBTH. The youths of today do not understand those they are dealing with. They are dealing with old warriors, old oligarchists who know how to fight. One of the things they are going to do is that they are going to use fear. Fear and intimidation. They might roll the army out very soon and they will shoot a few youths dead to intimidate others to run into their shells. The next thing they will do is to start arresting people piecemeal by piecemeal. They will target somebody, arrest that person, target another person, arrest another person, and before you know it, fear will start creeping into the system. Then the next thing they do is assassination. Remember Kudirat? They will start eliminating people one after the other. Remember Kokori, Frank Kokori, and the rest that they arrested during the Nupen crisis, during June 12 crisis. They will start eliminating people one after the other, either by assassinating them, by imprisoning them. They will drive them out of the country. Remember Nadeko, they will run into exile. But if you don't give up, some of those oppressing people today are beneficiaries of the struggle of people like Enahoro and the rest others who did not benefit much from the struggle. And so, they will want to fight back. Another system they use is to get hungry young men and individuals who are instruments that suffer from the Stockholm syndrome, I told you. Remember Abacha's crisis? There was one young Igbo boy. I think it's Kanu that established one group. They went to Abuja, held conferences, held rallies to support.